Hi, my name is Corey from East Coast DIY. And today I'm going to give you a tutorial on how I transform my closet from this to this. The dimensions of the closet are 113 inches by 82 inches. For one side of the closet, I will be using the IKEA PAX system. And for the other side of the closet, I will be using pine boards from Lowe's. I started by measuring out the length of this wall, which is 113 inches. IKEA sells the PAX wardrobe frames in three different sizes: 39 inches, 29 inches, and 19 inches. I already had two of the 39-inch wardrobe frames from another project that I will be using in here, and I also purchased a third one at 29 inches. This will leave me a little bit of space in between, and I plan on trimming it out to give it a custom built-in look. And here's screenshots of the drawers, shelves, and clothes rails that I also purchased from IKEA. And in the video right here, I am installing a shoe compartment that I also bought from IKEA. However, I do not see that available on their website. After I moved both of the 39-inch frames into the closet, I assembled the 29-inch. And when moving the frame, I would definitely suggest a second person to help so you're not dragging it along the floor. Unfortunately, I didn't have the extra hand, so that's what I did here. Okay, so now all three units are in. That's a 39-inch, 39-inch, and then a 29-inch at the end. And to give it that built-in look, I'm going to be filling in the spaces in between each of the frames. I bought 1x3 primed pine boards that I will be putting in the middle with liquid nail and also brad nails. Along the bottom, I will be putting a primed 1x6. And then along the top, I will be putting a primed 1x4. Before I secured them to the wall and started with the trim, I wanted to add a little bit of character, so I added this peel and stick wallpaper to give it that coastal vibe to match the rest of the house. I bought it from Amazon and I will link it in my Amazon shop for you. Okay, so here I laid the 1x6 primed pine board right across the bottom so you can see that built-in look I'm going for. I evenly spaced out all of the wardrobe frames and then attached them to the wall. So now you can see the spacing that's in between each of the wardrobe frames and in between the wall. This is the 1x3 primed pine that I'm going to be putting in between each section. And depending on the size of your closets, the gap that's in between your frames might be a little bit different. So if you have a larger gap, you might want to go to a 1x4 in between each section. Or if you have a smaller gap, you can either rip down the board to fit or a 1x2. Here's what it's going to look like when it's in between each section. And to attach it to the frames, I plan on using liquid nail and then also my brad nailer to hold it in place. For the trim, I bought one 12-foot 1x6, one 12-foot 1x4, and four 8-foot 1x3s. I cut the 1x6 and 1x4 down to 113 inches, which is the length of my closet. I cut the four 1x3s down to 71.5 inches. You can adjust that height depending on where you want the 1x4 to sit on the upper frame. And when installing the trim in between the frames, I did notice that some of the gaps weren't completely the same, so I did make a few adjustments as I was going on. To add a little character to the drawers, I am using PVC lattice trim that I bought from Home Depot. And recently at IKEA, they started selling the framed front drawers, so if you are able to find those, this would save you that step. And here I am adding the lattice trim to the drawers to give it that shaker style. And I didn't want to leave as much space in between the drawers and the frame, so I cut the horizontal pieces at 36.5 inches. The vertical pieces I cut to 4 1/8. And before you cut both of those measurements, I would definitely double check just to make sure that your distance is the same as my drawers. I used Power Grab and my brad nailer with 5/8 inch brad nails. Make sure the brad nails you are using are small so they don't go through the drawer. To finish customizing the closet, I bought black handles from Amazon. I am centering the handles to the drawers using my cabinet jig, making the hole with my drill, and then using the screwdriver to install the handles. And to have this shelf sit flush with the outside trim, I'm just adding a 1x2. Now that all of my trim is installed, I'm just going to go around with the caulk gun and just caulk all of the seams. And here's the color match code for the IKEA PAX unit. I do recommend painting all of your trim with it. And then to fill in all of these holes, they actually sell these little pegs from IKEA. I didn't buy nearly enough, so I did go ahead and just finish it off by caulking in the rest of the holes. I do suggest waiting to do this last though until you have all of your accessories in place. And now to the right side of the closet. For this side of the closet, I am not using the IKEA PAX system. Instead, I bought 2x4s and pine boards from Lowe's. I started out by cutting two 2x4s the length of the closet. And I used my stud finder to mark all of the studs along that wall. When your home is framed, the studs are usually located 16 or 24 inches apart. I started out by making a base out of the 2x4s. The front and back of the base I cut to the length of the closet. And to give the base additional support, I cut 2x4s to 13 inches. To attach the 2x4s together, I am using 3-inch long wood screws. And if I were to do this again, I would recommend to make the entire base first before attaching it to the wall. This would allow you to screw in those support 2x4s easier from the front and the back. And here's a picture of the 16-inch pine boards that I'm going to be using on top of the base, as well as the rest of the frame in the closet. I cut it down to the length of the closet, sat it on top of the base, and used my brad nailer to secure it. Looking back at it now, I wish I would have made the base and the frame completely separate on the ground and then just stood it up in place. This would have allowed me to use my corner clamps to make sure everything was nice and square. Building it this way, I was having to fight a little bit with the unlevelness of the floor and also the walls. So now it's time to build the actual frame. I didn't want the pine boards sitting flush up against the wall because I wanted a little bit of a gap so I would be able to frame it out like I did the IKEA side with 1x3s. So to give it that gap, I just put two small 2x4s up against the wall and attached it to the stud and then attached the pine board to that. I cut all of the upright pine boards to 75 3/4 inches. This will give me about the same finished height as the IKEA side. And to give support to the top board as well as the middle board, I cut a 2x4 to the distance in between and attached it to the stud using 3-inch screws. And I did the same thing in the middle as well. I then just screwed that middle frame to the 2x4s for additional support. So here's what it looks like. I'm going to be wrapping the 1x6 around so it looks like a built-in. And then I'm going to be adding shelves to in between along with the entire top just to make 4 equal sections on this side of the closet. I cut one of the 16-inch boards to fit and then attached it to that back 2x4 with my brad nailer. The shelf needed a little bit more support, so I cut a 2x4 down to 8 inches to add support to each side. And I wanted the middle section to have a little gap in between so I could frame it out with a 1x3 on the front to match the IKEA side. So I just used a piece of scrap 1x4 that I had and positioned it in between the two boards. And for the top shelf, I just cut it to the length of the closet. Now I just have to do it all over for this side. So I'm using my stud finder to find my studs and then attaching a 2x4 to the top for support as well as the middle. I cut the board to length, attached it with my brad nailer, and then added 2x4s to each side for support. To give it that built-in look, I bought 1 8-foot 1x6 primed pine board that I'm cutting to the length of the closet. And I just attached it to the bottom base with my brad nailer. And to fill the gap between the frames and the wall, I'm using primed pine 1x3s that I cut to 71.5 inches. And adding a 1x4 primed pine to the top. And to attach those, I'm just using power grab and my brad nailer. Now that the entire frame is built, I'm just caulking all of the seams. And like I had mentioned before, if I were to do this all over again, I would probably build this down on the ground. It would make it a lot easier and then just stand it up on that base. After the caulking dried, I gave it a nice sand and then I prepped the area for primer and paint. And for the primer, I am using Valspar bonding agent from Lowe's. And I want it to match the same color as the IKEA side, so I'm using that same color match code from the IKEA side. Here it is if you want to take a screenshot of that. And I'm going to be adding 4 clothes rails to each section. I bought the hardware from Lowe's. And I'm attaching it 12 inches out from the wall. They sell adjustable rods or you can cut it to size. And then I added a mirror and light for some decor. The entire closet cost $800 for all of the material. And I'll also make sure to put all of the materials in the comments for you. The drawers provide so much space. I also bought these organizers from IKEA, which just allows me to separate everything to keep me as organized as possible. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I also have more details right on my Instagram page at East Coast Florida DIY. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you subscribe.